to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we use the digital readout computer to tell us where to place the lay tool to turn a radius. So I'll go through how you set it up and we'll have a look at the type of radius you get. But first of all, we have the draw for the digital calipers. I have two of these to give away, so I'll be drawing two people and they will get the caliper sent to them. So I have the bowl for the draw and I'll draw one out for the first caliper. First one is Colin Brown. Up so you can see. The second one is Dave Hill. So those are the two caliper winners, and I'll send these off to you. I've had a few questions from some of the viewers on why I do certain things on the Boxford lathe. So it's easier to show you on the lathe. So let's go into the workshop. And I'll answer those questions and show you how to turn a radius using the digital readouts.
I had a comment from one of the viewers who said, why do I always use my screw cutting lead screw as a traverse? Well, on the Boxford, there is no other shaft as a traverse. Some lathes have a separate shaft underneath which works a traverse. On the Boxford, there's one shaft that does screw cutting and the traverse. And the way it does that, the traverse is driven from a peg inside that fits into this groove along the lead screw. For the traverse, you engage this lever here, one for the saddle, one for the cross slide, and the middle is neutral. And for screw cutting, you engage the half nuts on this lever, which closes the half nuts onto the lead screw. So when you're using the traverse, you're not using the screw cutting lead screw, you're using the drive in the slot with the pegging that drives the traverse. I'll show you how it works. Now if I engage the half nuts to engage the screw cutting, you can see it moves along. If I engage the traverse, I'll tighten this up and you can see the top going round. To reverse that, all I do is move a lever to change to reverse gear. This will go in under the clutch, select neutral. If it's in drive, I can't engage a screw cutting half nuts.
Had another question from one of the viewers who said, why do I turn my tool when I'm cutting a radius on the end of a bar? Why don't I just turn both the top slide and the compound slide to form the radius? I think I'll show you with the digital readout why it's very difficult to form a radius using the two slides by hand at the same time. It's difficult enough using the computer to tell you where to go. Let me show you how to use the digital readout to form a radius. First thing is zero your tool position so you're on center line and you're at the end of the bar that you want to form a radius on. So you zero the two positions. Then make sure you're in millimetres. This is because the scales are in millimetres. The calculations are done in millimetres, so it's easier to do it in millimetres. Once you've set your zero and your X and Y to zero, next thing you do, enter the radius mode here. And the first thing it's asking me is it X and Y that the radius is in? That's because if you're using a milling machine, it could be X and Z. So on a lathe, it's usually X and Y. Now that's okay. So then using the arrows, scroll through the menu for the next question, which is, what type of radius is it? If you look on your display, you will see there are 8 different types of radius, and the difference is your starting and ending position. On this, you start at 0 and end wherever the radius ends. So on the lathe, I'm using this one, which is number 3, or you could use number 8. A fine number 8 works backwards, but I'm using number 3. So I'm putting a radius from 0 round, and that seems to work okay on this machine.
If you're having problems forming the radius, check that your positive and negative directions are reading the correct way. Or you could try one of the other 8 processing planes, which may give you a better result.
I don't know if having it on diameter rather than radius in the setup changes anything on that. I don't think it does. On the lathe, if you've set this up so that when you move a millimetre out, it shows 2 millimetres off the diameter, I don't think that's any different to if it just showed 1 millimetre. The positions for the radius are still the same. So you select which way you're going to do the radius. A lot of this is for the milling cutters and to say whether you're going internal or external. So on a lathe you don't have a lot of those. So I've selected type 3 and I've got, it says type in 1 to 8 and I've put in 3. Next question it's asking me is the tool plus or negative, because you could be inside a hole or you could be on the outside like we are of a bar. So in this condition the tool's on the outside, so it's plus. Enter the radius, so I want to put the 7.5 mil radius on the end. It's asking me the tool diameter. Well, it's not a milling cutter, so I've just put in 0 because it doesn't have to take into account the diameter of the tool. And also here it's saying Z step, it's not the Z axis, it's saying what steps will form the radius. I've put 1 millimetre, so there will probably be about 14 steps to form that radius. If you go to 0.5 millimetre, you'll probably have 28 steps to form the radius, which is a lot of steps, but the radius would be more smoother than 14 steps. Then you go to the next one and it's send size, position 1 is 0, 0. Now that's where I've got the tool set, which is in the centre of the bar, touching the end of the bar. This is a start position on centre line of the bar at 0 and the end of the bar at 0 in the 2 axes.
I've already roughed out the bar so I don't have too much material to move in one step.
So the next thing you do is go to position 2 and it's telling me that's where it is and I have to move the saddle and the cross slide to get those 2 readings to 0. Now you'll see why it's difficult to turn a radius by hand, because this one has to move a lot farther than this one. And what you're trying to do is get them to come to 0 at the same time, so you have to turn this one a lot faster than this one. It's telling me to move nearly a millimetre out and 0.65 across. Move to point 3. quite full. Point six. Seven. Well, thirteen. 1. So you can see sort of radius you get. It's very difficult to turn that exactly because you're not turning equal amounts off and it's changing as you're going through the radius. Plus sometimes you probably pay to rough it out first and then do it again on the computer, because sometimes you're trying to move millimeter of material away. You can see it does form a rough radius, gives you a guide, I suppose.
I did do this again, and this time I changed the z-step to 0.5 of a mil, which gave me double the number of cutting steps.
That's the diameter. It's still rough, but you can see it's a bit easier to machine actually with more points, because you're not taking so much off on each cut. So I don't think this is going to make the ball turning fixture redundant.
Well, that's it for today. I hope that was interesting. Hope you've learned something new. And we'll see you next time on Enoch's Engineering.